Good afternoon and welcome to Minute Mix Tips. Today I want to talk about some terminology, some semantics, and it stems from a question I got from a friend of mine who'd been watching the videos and who said enjoy them, but hey, what's the difference between a compressor and a limiter? And I want to just talk about that very quickly. It's not a big deal, although compressors are a big deal. So I chose a song that was recorded by my friend Jamie Houston on a band called Levon. And he recorded this vocal with no compression, no limiting, no EQ, just straight flat from the preamp to the audio station. And let's give a listen to it right now. It's going to give us a nice platform from which to listen and affect. Here's the whole track from just before the verse. I was busy flunking this is with my effects on it. Year of college, working hard, tending bar, soaking up all the knowledge. By effects, I mean the compressors. Serving wine to the ladies and equalizers. Jessica's porch. Okay, so we can see first off, just by taking a look at the waveform, that it is in fact not compressed or limited. So let's talk first of all, the object of this minute mix tip is what is the difference between compressing and limiting? And for me, it comes down to the compression ratio. So this is a signal dependent limiter. Input reaches the stage of a gain reduction, and then the gain reduction circuitry takes effect. Limiters and compressors both make loud signals softer and soft signals louder. And for me, compression ratio settings from 4 to 1 and below are compressors. That same device with a compression ratio setting of 8 to 1 or above make it a limiter, without changing the characteristics of the knee, but rather just the amount of ratio applied to the signal above the threshold. Okay, so let's listen to this vocal. I have this compressor set as a compressor at a 4 to 1 ratio, and listen. I was busy flunking now of my third year of college, working hard.
So that's really affecting
soaking up all the knowledge you can find, serving wine to of the ladies signal at Francesca's porch. But as you can see, much less gain reduction is applied to these lower level passages than these peaks. If I were to go to a ratio setting of 20 to 1, let's see what happens. I was busy flunking now of my third year of college, working hard, tending bar, soaking up all the knowledge you can find, serving wine to the ladies at Francesca's porch. So as you can see very clearly, this compressor set at a ratio of 20 to 1 also changed the threshold setting of that compressor. It did not allow any changes to the signal at the lower levels. I'm not going to go into the science of this, just the effect. But it grabbed the peaks very, very nicely. So at 20 to 1, this unit with no changes to the input, output, attack, or release switched from being a compressor to a limiter, grabbing only the peaks and leaving the average program signal alone completely. By the way, this SSL compressor is a DBX gain reduction model, and I have this set at a very low ratio, 1.5, and it's barely doing anything. I was using this SSL channel as an equalizer more than a compressor, but you can see it is grabbing some of the things. And this has a unique structure in that the threshold setting also adds a makeup gain. So the higher you turn up this threshold, the more makeup gain you're delivering to the output here. And therefore, this is set to be a gain boost with some slight peak limiting, even at this very low ratio, because of the unusual characteristics of this particular circuit.
Let's show you something that really illustrates the peak reduction possibilities in limiting. So this is strictly a limiter. It's program dependent. Watch what happens.
I was busy flunking out of my third year of college, working hard.
Nothing's going on until I start adding gain.
You can find serving wine to the ladies at Francesca's porch.
Hear all that distortion creep in?
She walked in with her friends, they were mad celebrating.
So as I lower this input gain, I'm pretty certain I'm only going to get peak reduction, but with makeup gain.
The ladies all roared, Miss Mary.
This kind of works like the famous L1 peak limiter. But it's a nice illustration.
Come on, limiting is taking place.
So I'm getting makeup gain everywhere, but these very loud peak transients. Thank you, Jamie Houston, for giving us that untouched vocal file to show these three different styles of how to compress or limit a vocal. Hope you enjoyed that. Hope it brought some clarity to the difference between compressing and limiting. And happy mixing. See you next time.